So here's the thing about learning to identify trees. A lot of times we're given too much information. So if you look at these field guides, they might have hundreds of different tree species. And with each of these tree species, they have tons of different traits. Every tree has a fruit and a flower, has bark characteristics and twig characteristics. And in most cases, while those things are good to know, they're not actually essential to helping you identify a tree. So what I'm really excited about is giving you just the information that you need to know to identify that tree, and then you can learn all that other stuff later. A perfect example of this is white birch, also called paper birch. White birch has all of these different characteristics which are really neat to know, but to identify it, all you need to know is that it's the only tree with white, peely bark. All of our birch species share certain bark characteristics. They all have what are called lenticels, which are these horizontal dashes across their bark. And they all have bark that peels horizontally rather than vertically. Almost every other tree species has bark that will peel vertically if it peels at all. In the case of paper birch, the bark can peel in these broad, flat sheets, like sheets of paper. That's why we call it paper birch. And it's the only tree in the forest that does that. So if you see a tree in the forest with white bark that's peeling in horizontal sheets, you know that it's paper birch. You don't need any more information. The only other tree species that you might confuse with paper birch is gray birch. Gray birch is very closely related to paper birch. The only difference is that while both species have whitish bark, gray birch bark will not be peely. It'll look like a small diameter white birch. Usually gray birches won't get any more than 4 or 5 inches in diameter. That's not peely and that has many more of these horizontal dashes that lend its bark less of a straight up white appearance and more of a gray coloration. The other characteristic that you can use to distinguish gray birch from white birch is that while white birch will have large limbs with that same white bark as their trunk, gray birch will only have these spindly little branches with a darker colored bark that sort of loop downwards. So white birch is one of our shade intolerant tree species. Usually if you have white birch in your forest, you have a generation of white birch that are all the same age. The reason for this is because white birch can only grow out in the open. So the presence of white birch is the indicator of a past large-scale disturbance or maybe a forest that regenerated in a field. If you can tell the age of a white birch tree, it'll tell you how many years ago that disturbance occurred. So if you have a generation of white birch trees in your forest and you cut one down and you count the rings and you see that it's 60 years old, that tells you that there is a large-scale natural disturbance or large-scale logging or field abandonment that occurred on that site 60 years ago. White birch is really fast-growing and pretty short-lived. So compared to sugar maple, which might live to be 200 to 300 years old, white birch will usually live 60 to 80 years. But a white birch that's 40 years old might be quadruple the size of a sugar maple that's 40 years old. Stay tuned for some more videos on tree identification, and please like and subscribe.